Now he's just looking for a first down. Straight ahead, Matt Kalipinski, the fullback, close to the first down. Straight ahead. And let's wait and see. West Virginia says no way.
Once again, another good call about going straight up the middle with a team playing against the West Virginia defense that's going to be so conscious of Lamont Jordan. Their linebackers were at the line of scrimmage, trying to get an upfield rush so he can't get lateral on them. And then you go with the quarterback sneaking and leave it to your strong safety Hackett to make the stop.
First down, not by much.
Being so conscious of the run, you're going to make an outside rush. That leaves your strong safety Hackett right there at the top of the pile, number 10. To have to be in the middle and make that stop. It's a tough play for a strong safety.
McCall's got a man open and it's caught. A tumbling catch by Jeff Dugan, who had he kept his feet would have scored.
Another victim of the turf, and also again, the West Virginia defense is so conscious of two great athletes in the backfield that are playing very aggressively. That time, Grant Wiley, the outside linebacker, was a little too aggressive and allowed Dugan to get in behind him.
Jeff Dugan, the redshirt freshman, a 17-yard reception. And Calvin McCall has been muddy so far. First and goal. Jordan, nowhere to go. Grant Wiley, the freshman, with a big hit. They are really high on Wiley here in Morgantown. It's not often that you get a freshman that walks into Steve Dunlap's defense and makes a difference.
And he's a guy who replaced Barrett Green, who was a big-time player for West Virginia for many years. Antoine Lake, number 87, is the first one on the scene. And there's Wiley, number 6. And there's that gang tackling that West Virginia has been so famous for over the years.
Second and goal. Jordan again. And again he stopped. David Carter this time, who lost a shoe, but got Lamont Jordan.
West Virginia has everyone's been talking about Maryland's linebackers and how they're one of the best crews in the country, but this is an excellent crew of linebackers right there. Corey Emmons is the veteran, been around a long time. We saw David Carter on that last stop. And Caden will share time with McIntyre. They feel those two guys are equal, so they have five good linebackers.
Maryland 0 for 4 on third down today. On third and goal, it's Jordan. He's going nowhere. James Davis, another linebacker, makes the stop. He came in for Carter, who lost his shoe.
And Don Nealon says, we haven't forgotten how to play defense, and West Virginia has come up big when it counts in the red zone two times. They have been looking for Jordan. We say it every time they go away from Jordan, they get something big. When they go to Jordan, these guys are keyed in. And James Davis is the first one on the scene, comes up with a big stop, tackling Jordan high.
Brian Kopka for the field goal attempt. And Kopka hits it from 27 yards. Maryland is on the board, but West Virginia with a nice defensive stand. 7-3 Mountaineers. Sean Terry, 5 yards deep. 7-3, West Virginia on top of Maryland. Don Nealon in West Virginia had Michael Vick beaten last year in this stadium. And it was a miracle comeback. That gave Nealon an indication. indication that this year wouldn't be so bad. Virginia Tech game late in the season.
And one thing he did get in that game was good production from Brad Lewis coming off the bench at the quarterback position. He was very pleased with Lewis's maturity and how quickly he came along in that game.
Mark Bulger was hurt at various points during the year. Lewis had 3 starts, but he played an awful lot in that Virginia Tech game. Wes Hours in motion. Cooper Rego, the carry. Let's go back to that this year. I think a lot of people are surprised at how well they played at home against Boston College. They wiped out BC in their opener, 34-14.
There were a lot of unknowns for West Virginia in the opening game. They've played so uncharacteristically over the last year and a half, that they really want to see if they can come back and be the team of old.
Lewis's throw is a good one, and it's caught. Corey Ivey with the catch.
And that's a big strike by Lewis, showing a nice strong arm in there. Corey Ivey now goes 30 consecutive games with a catch.
Third down and one. That's 29 straight now for Ivey. Rego has the first down. This is the 21st consecutive season that these two schools have met. It's not a big rivalry game, but it is a barometer game, right, Nick Lowry?
Exactly, guys. In the seasons when West Virginia beats Maryland, they average about 8 wins a season. Now, in those seasons when they lose to Maryland, they're barely winning 5 games.
Ouch. And they don't go to bowls as often as they do when they beat the Terrapins. Last year, the Terrapins waxed West Virginia. It was the worst loss for West Virginia since 1976. 33-0. Lewis going deep for Ivy. Incomplete, flags down. 2 of them. Caron Cox on the coverage of Corey Ivy.
Well, Caron Cox that time is a victim of the underthrown deep ball, the most dangerous play to defend. One, because the defensive back can't see the ball in the air, so the receiver can always come back to it. It's a big play when it's completed, but it also puts the defensive back in an awkward position.
Defensive pass interference, 15 yards from the previous spot, automatic first down.
It puts that defensive back in an awkward position. Corey Ivey to the right of your screen, just going to run a go route. And Caron Cox is behind him, so he cannot see the ball. He gets called for the defensive pass interference, but he really doesn't even know that the ball's in the air. It's a tough position for a defensive back to be in, especially a young man like Caron Cox.
Redshirt freshman out of Arlington, Virginia. Rego to midfield, a 3-yard carry.
Cooper Rego was 2 yards down past the line of scrimmage before he met anyone. It was the movement of the West Virginia offensive line. They call that reestablishing the line of scrimmage. Move the defensive line back 2 or 3 yards, reestablish the line of scrimmage after the snap of the ball.
We see so many coaches talk about getting a backup quarterback, a series, a half. A lot of coaches do the same with tailbacks, and that's what West Virginia is doing right now with Cooper Rego, getting him a series. Lewis is on the money again, and Brown trying to escape the clutches of O'Connellan. Flags go down. 13 yards on the pickup.
Both of these teams are so conscious of the run, it's opening up the pass game, especially the man-to-man coverage to the wide side of the field. Linebackers are playing in tight to the line of scrimmage, and it opens up those deep passing lanes.
Vanderlinden not happy with this call.
5 yard face pass. The defense penalized from the end of the run. First down.
Just a 5 yard call on a common one. Anytime it's a 5 yard, it's probably nothing flagrant. A common one just gets his hands just right there on the face mask. It's a little bit of a slap. That's enough for a 5 yarder. Didn't look like much.
On first and 10, Avon Coburn's back in. He's swallowed up at the 30-yard line. Quickly.
Prentice is a lot like Calvin McCall in that he can take advantage of having a good running back in the ballgame.
He's also a lot like Brad Lewis, the quarterback for West Virginia. They are two of the strongest quarterbacks in college football in terms of bench presses. Lewis is about 375 and Prentice is about 350. Flags down. Lewis lost the football. And who's got it? What a wild play that was. West Virginia has the ball. A flag is back at the 30-yard line.
Yesterday, Don Nealon not only talked about the toughness of Brad Lewis, but also talked about Avon Coburn and his backs, Avon Coburn and Rigo, how they work down the field without the football in their hands.
An inadvertent flag, they've picked it up, so this is going to be a nice game for West Virginia.
And Rigo made a nice block down the field, coming back to help his quarterback out.
Phil Braxton, the sophomore wide receiver, will come into your screen shortly. There is Braxton at the bottom of the pile, recovered the football. And look at the game. It's all the way down to the 17-yard line.
Like I said, we'll take it anywhere we get it.
Tripped up. A nice play by Tony Jackson, the strong safety out of Elliott, Maryland. And he's playing with a sore shoulder.
And it's going to get a lot more sore if he has to keep coming up and hitting running backs.
West Virginia's rushing yardage. Two of their biggest plays in rushing have been broken plays with Brad Lewis. He scored on a 12-yard touchdown on that last pickup. On second down, Lewis to the end zone. Ivy, touchdown.
Make his moves down the field.
Extra point, no good. West Virginia misses the kick. 13-3 is the score. Corey Ivey from Brad Lewis. Right tackle, big kid out of Princeton, West Virginia, 6'8", 325. Sikiala will take a knee. A look at the touchdown.
Coming in from the right side of the screen, Corey Ivey's going to make his moves. Brad Lewis goes the opposite way, just right in front of Tony Jackson, right there. Corey Ivey slips into the end zone, and Brad Lewis had plenty of time to throw the football. That offensive line is doing a tremendous job, not only reestablishing the line of scrimmage, and to the right of your screen is Tanner Russell. And if you don't think that Brad Lewis is one of those guys, they love this guy, and Tanner Russell loves the game of football, baby.
Maryland with the rain starting to fall. Julian Gary to the 34-yard line. Richard Bryant made the stop. That's 14 yards on the pickup. There's your scoring drive, and there's Tanner Russell, who we got to meet yesterday at a lunch with the captains.
He is a hard-working guy. They say he's not the most gifted athlete, but he's a hard-working guy. About 330 pounds and can't even touch his toes.
Lamont Jordan to the 37-yard line. From the 36. McCall to Jordan. makes the stop. The umpire escaped the hit. It'll bring up third down. Third down. McCall. Incomplete. I'm not sure who averaged 54 yards last week. He's only averaging 30 yards this week. And West Virginia almost got it. They do hit the kicker. Flag is down. And Barnhart is down. And that is a 60-yarder. And I would expect a 15-yard penalty coming up.
Well, I think you'll get the 15-yard because Barnhart got up limping a little bit, but I don't know that it was that flagrant of a foul.
It was fourth down and five, so if it's running into the kicker, 5 yards will be very close to a first down. Seth Abraham was the Mountaineer who almost blocked it and then made contact.
That's a good call, Rich. Either way they go with it, they'll get the first down on this play.
Running into the kicker, 5-yard penalty, results in a first down.
So they get the five in the first down.
And it wasn't a flagrant. I don't even know if Abraham actually hit him. I think he just brushed right by him. He may have gotten his foot just a tad. But then kickers have to be a little bit, you know, they have to go for that Academy Award here. Not enough to really knock him down, but go down, roll over, get up limping, and we'll get the laundry.
I would agree. 5 yards is enough for that one. Jordan is a good thrower, and he's got a man. Monroe can't make the catch. It was an incredible effort by Lamont Jordan just to get rid of the ball.
Great play selection by Maryland, but even better defense by West Virginia. Strong pursuit by the linebackers on Jordan. Didn't allow him a chance to set his feet. Number 41 is Corey Edmonds. He makes a nice job pushing up the field. Doesn't allow him to set his feet. And Scooter Monroe, there's nobody anywhere near him.
Lamont Jordan has thrown 2 touchdown passes in his career. And he almost had his third. Second down. McCall. And the quarterback, Calvin McCall, to the 48-yard line.
And Jordan almost had a touchdown pass to his credit. He knew all he had to do was throw this ball up there because Scooter Monroe was so wide open. That's a tough ball to track, especially when it's raining and the wind is blowing, moving that ball around. Scooter Monroe, with that ball tailing the way it was, tough ball to track.
The rain continues to fall. 0-6 on third down are the Terrapins. Intercepted. Richard Bryant of West Virginia brings it out to the 37-yard line, and they like what they see in Morgantown. This West Virginia defense duplicating what they accomplished against Boston College.
And Don Nealon has to be impressed with the way his defense is playing. That time Calvin McCall just put that ball out there. And Richard Bryant did a nice job of using the field. He's to the wide side of the field. Just using the field because he knows that Scooter Monroe has to go down the sideline. And that's a long throw and an ill-advised pass by Calvin McCall. That ball's in the air a long time. That gives Bryant enough time to get underneath it. You see that rain is starting to pick up a little bit. And that's definitely going to be to the advantage of West Virginia. Plays on turf a lot more.
And a flag after the play will add 15 yards. The weather is changing. Right, Nick Lowry?
Yeah, it's doubled in intensity. The wind is not only pushing the ball down the field, you saw that on the halfback pass, but also to the left, which brought it a little bit out of the reach of the receiver and caused, I think, the interception.
All right, thanks, Nick. The ball is in Maryland territory, a personal foul, a dead ball foul against Maryland after the return. Brad Lewis and the Mountaineers trying to stay dry. This is the third time West Virginia has started a possession in Maryland territory. Coburn. Another 10-yard pickup for Avon Coburn. First down, West Virginia. Coburn to the 30, seven more yards. 5'9", 195, and Avon Coburn is having a good day so far. 80 yards on 11 carries.
Avon Coburn running behind that big offensive line, and his fullback, Wes Hours, opening up some huge holes in there.
Throw caught by Ivy, out of bounds at the 3. Coburn to the 10, to the 7.
West Virginia is just clearly dominating the line of scrimmage. You see the movement by the West Virginia offensive line. That's Dixon, the left tackle, pushes out right there. Opening that hole on Roundtree. That opens up the hole. They're big, but they also have good movement. You saw Dixon pull and kick out Roundtree. Great movement and great feet.
Get turned around in time. Stops the clock. Second down and goal. Denard Wilson on the coverage. Ivy already has a score today.
This is textbook play selection by West Virginia. Run the ball with some power, go play action. You see the linebacker sucked in there. Makes the job of Corey Ivy very easy. He's got plenty of room to work, no one underneath. Just didn't get his hand around quick enough on that play.
Second and goal, Cooper Rego in the game for West Virginia. And this is Rego. Rego didn't quite make it. To the 1, it'll be 4th and goal from the 1.
So much has been talked about this Maryland front and especially their linebackers.
Check it, 3rd and goal from the 1.
They're playing very aggressive up front. They're taking a look at Coburn on the sideline. We'll have to keep an eye on him, but Cooper Rego has done a fine job in his replace.
On 3rd and goal. Rego. Nowhere to go. E.J. Henderson made the stop. Timeout, West Virginia. Flags down. Clock is stopped with the flag. West Virginia was ready to burn the timeout, and they'll wait to see offsides against Maryland.
Don Neely is telling Cooper Rego right now.
Defense, half the distance to the goal, repeat 3rd down.
Don Neely was telling Cooper Rego to hit the corner. Get there, don't waste time. He stutter step looking back inside. Richard talked earlier about Cooper Rego getting some reps in the game, getting different looks. He needs to know when to hit it. And there's the reason why Avon Coburn is limping there on the sideline.
Rego in the game. 3rd and goal again. Rego, touchdown, West Virginia. Behind Brad Connell and Tanner Russell.
Definitely payback time for West Virginia. This is a big series back and forth. Maryland's only a 3-hour drive from here, so all these players are recruited by both the same schools.
Point is up and good. West Virginia off to a good start in this one, 20-3. Cooper Rego quick to get in there and thank his offensive line for providing the hole on that last touchdown run. That big offensive line of West Virginia is really something.
And you talked about that right side. And Wes Hours right there, number 40, opening up those holes on the outside. He has been so valuable on that last drive, especially when the wind changed. And Sean Burton, the tight end, opening up that seam. Those two guys are two big guys, and Wes Hours is actually bigger than Sean Burton.
Wes Hours is bigger than most offensive linemen. He's a 290-pound fullback, and they use him as an extra tight end as well.
And Wes Hours was wanting to go to Maryland and was told by Maryland that he was not a Division I ball player. So this game has an added meaning for him as well.
A wet football. And Kalipinski returns it out to the 44-yard line. We'll be back to West Virginia after this. Coming up on ABC at 3:30 Eastern. Kalipinski over the left side. Go, had to let go, Mr. Vanderlinden, because Maryland came calling. And of course, Jerry Barnett now in Colorado. West Virginia trying to make this a bounce back season. And so far, so good. 20-3 at halftime to the studios.